Here we are on this island we call a world. Like shipwrecked sailors. And we're wondering, what is this place really? Well, it's really an expression of our continuity fear. It is the continuity fear expressing itself. It's expressing itself in the form of failure. We want to fail to drop the continuity fear. We want to keep the continuity fear. We want to stay afraid of what is truly within us, which is this great, great, great good news. We all know there's something within us that is like off the charts, completely off the charts, and we're afraid of it, very much afraid of it. This is the continuity fear. We want to avoid that at all costs. We think that somehow we would lose our awareness, our being, our identity, we would feel disoriented. We would feel confused. We're afraid of this something so great within us that it scares us. And so this expresses itself in a very severe continuity fear. And that continuity fear, unacknowledged, but just followed as if it was a guide to happiness, safety, results in us being here on this, you know, desert island we call the world. How to divest ourselves of this world is the question, right? For most of us. Some just keep thinking that they want to stay here forever, but most of us realize, you know, it may be an interesting place to visit, but sure wouldn't want to live here. So we have to divest ourselves of this world and everything that goes with it, which includes mortality, morbidity, suffering, invulnerability, the whole nine yards of all the misery here. That goes to, we must divest ourselves of that. And we must accept this great good news within us. This great good news within us. So we have to gradually work at this and get less and less frightened of what's within us. Okay, so we don't project the fear of that into an expression such as this world. Now, as long as we have this continuity fear, that continuity fear will be expressing itself. All right, guaranteed. No way around that. So those who say, well, all I have to do is let the morbidity of this body take place, and then I got no more problems. That's not true. The confusion and the continuity fear is a spiritual confusion, a spiritual continuity fear. Dropping of this body doesn't affect that in any way. So the continuity fear will continue to express itself, resulting that you will always have this expression of what is within. If you have a continuity fear, it's going to express itself, and you will feel that you're in a place that protects you from letting go of this fear. And we feel that to hold on to this fear is success. In other words, to fail to let go of it, we call that success. So we have a world here of failures, and we're all patting each other on the back saying, wow, how successful we are. But not everybody agrees with this. There are some who say, no, I want to evaporate the continuity fear, and I want to be able to accept what is within, and so I'm making it my responsibility and duty to do this. So when this is the attitude, then one goes through various phases. I call it the five phases. And as we go through these phases, we tend to project less and less and less attachment to the world, less neediness for the world, less interest in the world. And we feel like, hey, you know, I really probably don't need the world at all at some point soon here. I can accept this great good news within me, which will truly liberate me from any necessity to believe that I'm a body dwelling in a world of bound by laws of nature and all this. don't need the continuity fear. Therefore, the expression of the continuity fear goes with the continuity fear. As we evaporate it, the expression is no longer needed. That doesn't mean that we cannot remain here. It's just that there would be a complete, total seeing through of this expression of the continuity fear, and we would certainly see everything in a new light. Okay, it's called the vision of oneness. This is the fifth phase. We reach the fifth phase. We abide in the vision of oneness. So right now, these videos are focused on the fourth phase. Fourth phase. That's very, very advanced phase. That is true. But a lot of us have put in a lot of work. And the world, the expression of continuity fear that which this world is, the continuity fear is getting a lot worse. And so the expression of this continuity fear is getting much, much more severe. Much more severe. It's getting to the point where civilization will be built around the absolute sanctity of failing to let go of the continuity fear and enhancing it in every way possible. And anyone who disagrees with that is seen to be extraordinarily dangerous and needs to be out of the picture. So we want to be in the fourth phase now. We want to do everything we can do. We want to put the pedal to the metal. We want to accelerate. And so I woke up this morning, asked the Holy Spirit, can you help us? And the Holy Spirit said, sure, yes, here. And showed me this, something I could do. And I said, wow, okay, let me try. I think I can do that. So I've been working all day today. It's been a glorious California day, September day. And there's just, people are just everywhere doing stuff. And yet, here I am in my room, in this studio here, just writing and writing and thinking and structuring exercises for us that will help us greatly with the fourth phase. So this is what we need to do. We need to be dedicated. We need to be dedicated. And when you reach the fourth phase, you're very dedicated because you know the opportunity is there. You know failure is not an option, really. And so we do everything we can. So there will be some exercises coming up. Very intense exercises. Just in the structuring all these exercises, I felt like, wow. This is very, very intense stuff. It's supposed to be, but not too much. It just gradually builds up in you. Gradually, it's an evaporation process, okay? We're not doing anything but applying some heat to evaporate the continuity fear. That's all. So you'll feel some strain, you'll feel some stress. You'll feel like, wow, this is just, I can't wrap my mind around this. It's just like, ah, oh, wow. That's supposed to be like that. So, relish the opportunity to feel this. And what we say is, we simply practice full stop in the now. It's really, full stop in the now is really like Zen Buddhism. Essentially, Zazen. Zazen, I just was reading the description of Zazen. I said, wow, that's what we're doing here. I mean, part of what we're doing here, we're adding four-stage practice. There's more here, I would say. The sitting quietly, full stop in the burn, full stop in the burn of this consternation. You're not thinking ahead or behind or to the side. You're not having any expectations. You're just in this kind of sort of neutral state, quiet mind state, not expecting any success, not thinking of a path ahead or the path behind, not imagining, not struggling, not analyzing, not calculating, all of the mental activity, you're just kind of disinterested in it, actually. And you're just really full stop in the wow. Is another way to put it. You feel this, just this wow. this. I'm doing this exercise. This is just wow. I can't hardly believe I'm doing this. This is amazing. And just you just full stop in this wow. That's all that's necessary. So in reading that description of Zazen, I said, we've been doing that all along here. It is very helpful for sure. Don't anticipate. Don't project. Don't anticipate. Don't congratulate. Just stay in this calm, quiet mind. Hearing what is being said, and committed to not acting anything out, not grasping anything, acting anything out. Dialoguing, arguing, questioning, all of that. Just quiet, you're just quiet. So we're really organically using a lot of techniques that throughout history have been used by just those who have, you know, been inspired to do so. We're not trying to do this. It's just that these skillful means are being suggested by the Holy Spirit. So I'm saying, sure, okay. And there is some similarity historically to various techniques and skillful means, for sure. Again, we're not trying to correlate anything, we're not trying to connect anything, not trying to organize, categorize. Just full stop in the now, full stop in the burn, full stop in the wow. Okay. So, we have a lot of exercises to look forward to, actually. It's a very good thing. I was very prolific today. And I have the capacity to do that, having a lot of history and practice in musical composition. I'm able to sit down and really put a lot of creativity onto a page, so to speak. It's not difficult, but it does take some focus and willingness, for sure. So what we're going to do is we're going to do this very intense practice, fourth phase practice, for those who are very mature, those who are able to sit in this Zazen-like full stop in the now, just hearing, not trying to figure out how much progress am I making, no, and not being focused on the full stopness either, right? It's just present. Mindfulness, presentness, mindfulness, all of this, without trying to contrive it at all. You're just hanging in there with the wow and the burn. You're just hanging in there. Okay. So here's the form we're going to use. We're going to try this. We will try this. Give up all ... Give up all the good, for instance. Give up all the good. Give up all the bad. Abandon both the good and the bad. And relax into original nature. Okay. I'm going to put the negative one first though. So I'm going to say, give up all the bad. Give up all the bad. And give up all the good. Abandon all the bad and the good. And relax into original nature. Okay. So, again, this is a basic, powerful, evaporative technique here. Give up all fear. Give up all hope. Abandon all fear and all hope and relax into original nature. Give up all conflict. Give up all harmony. Abandon all conflict and harmony. And relax into original nature. Give up all lies. Give up all truth. Abandon all lies and truth. And relax into original nature. Give up all darkness. Give up all light. Abandon all darkness and all light. And relax into original nature. Give up all hatred. Give up all love. Abandon all hatred and all love. And relax into original nature. Give up all failure. Give up all success. Abandon all failure and all success. And relax into original nature. Give up all war. Give up all peace. Abandon all war and all peace, and relax into original nature. Give up all confusion. Give up all clarity. Abandon all confusion and all clarity, and relax into original nature. Give up all discomfort. Give up all ease. Abandon all discomfort and all ease, and relax into original nature. Give up all suffering. Give up all happiness. Abandon all suffering and all happiness, and relax into original nature. Give up all death. Give up all life. Abandon death and life. And relax into original nature. Give up all weariness. Give up all refreshment. Abandon all weariness and all refreshment, and relax into original nature. Give up all regressions. Give up all progress. Abandon all regressions and all progress, and relax into original nature. Give up all effort. Give up all rest. Abandon all effort and all rest, and relax into original nature. Give up all imprisonment. Give up all freedom. Abandon all imprisonment and all freedom, and relax into original nature. Give up all sickness. Give up all wellness. Abandon all sickness and all wellness, and relax into original nature. give up all form. Give up all formlessness. Relax into original nature. Give up all decay. Give up all growth. Abandon all decay and all growth and relax into original nature. Give up all motion. Give up all stillness. Abandon all motion and all stillness and relax into original nature. Abandon all ill will. I'm sorry, give up. Give up all ill will. Give up all compassion. Abandon all ill will and all compassion and relax into original nature. Give up all harshness. Give up all gentleness. Abandon all gentleness, all harshness, and all gentleness. And relax into original nature. Give up all problems. Give up all remedies. Abandon all problems and all remedies and relax into original nature. Give up all distortions. Give up all clarifications. Abandon all distortions and all clarifications and relax into original nature. Give up all destruction. Give up all construction. Abandon all destruction and all construction and relax into original nature. Give up all hurt. Give up all good feelings. Abandon all hurt and all good feelings and relax into original nature. Give up all damnation. Give up all salvation. Abandon all damnation and all salvation and relax into original nature. Okay, very great. That's just a little taste. You see, just a little taste. This is very powerful, very focused, very, very effective. So we'll do a little bit at a time here. I don't want to overload anyone. Now, I'm thinking about adding captions, subtitles for people in other languages. So everyone in the world will be able to, who wants to be able to do these phase four exercises, which are so crucial to do at this time, at this phase in the world, the way the world is going. We need to stand up to the world and what's going on and say, we have our own practices here. We have our own attention focused on this. We can focus our attention on phase four exercises. Yes, we can. And by putting our attention on this, we're able to keep it from being directed by the world, where the world wants our attention to go, which is truly to failure. To failure. Okay. These phase four exercises are directing the attention to success. To success. This opens the door to abiding in the vision of oneness. The world, well, if it gets a hold of your attention, is going to direct your attention to failure for sure. Very severe failure. So, these exercises are being made available to the world, and I'll try to make them available in all languages. So, everyone in the world, there's no excuse. We have options. We have options. By all means, please avail yourself of this option so that you can practice putting your attention onto these very high exalted type of practices. And this is the protection from this great conflict in the world, which is this battle over your attention. There is a war in this world, a world war for your attention. And so we need to win this war for ourselves, for sure. Because to allow our attention to get pulled into where the world wants it to go, we will truly be very badly misled. And we will continue to fail. That means we will continue to have very severe continuity fear. We will fear that great good news within us. And we will project this continuity fear out as an expression. And we will continue to inhabit this, you know, desert island. We will continue to be stuck with the expression of our continuity fear. And that is no picnic. That is no fun at all. Okay. Very great. And I will see what I can do to get this out to the world. That's it.